I always say that we try to limit or titrate or portion out the amount of time on this program we talk about Donald Trump, because everybody talks about Donald Trump and he's taking up all the oxygen. When we talk all the time on the left or liberal side of the spectrum about how much we hate Donald Trump, we're not talking about how to make the world a better place to live. We're not talking about how to make this country better. We're not talking about how to save lives. We're not talking about how to stop Big Pharma or expand Social Security or create Medicare for all. We're just talking about this one guy. But there are times to talk about Donald Trump, and when it makes sense, we will talk about it. And it kind of got, well, I don't want to say personal, but it kind of intersected with my own history to talk and think about Donald Trump recently, because while I was out of the country the last couple weeks, Donald Trump visited my hometown of Utica, New York. Now, for those of you who don't know, and I'll tell you more about Utica later, but Utica was the heart of was in the heart of the Rust Belt. We think of the Rust Belt, we think of Ohio and the Midwest. Utica, of course, is upstate New York, but it was a manufacturing city. When I was born there, it had a population, and when I was a little kid in the early 60s, it had a population, if I remember my statistics right, of about 106,000, and much of that population left. The area has been economically devastated by the collapse of American manufacturing. And when I was growing up in Utica, you could work at a gas station, you could have a regular working class job, you could work in one of the factories, one of the mills, and you could make a decent living, enough so that one parent could provide for an entire family. Again, decent life, like we had. Modest house, small, you know, maybe one car used, but you could live, and you could know that your kids would go to school, get an education, get a higher education if they wanted to, and you could do all that on one income. All that, of course, is dead and gone. Large sections of Utica fell to waste. Many homes were abandoned, including the home I grew up in, which is now, last I visited, abandoned and falling down. And they were selling crack out of the house next door. But Donald Trump, it's been doing a little bit better lately. We'll talk about that in a minute. Donald Trump visited Utica while I was away, supporting U.S. Representative Claudia Tenney, everybody forgets this. They think he's singularly evil. He's evil in a very Republican way, so he's helping the Republican member of Congress get reelected. So he went to Utica. He spoke at a private fundraiser at the DoubleTree there in support of Tenney's re-election. Now, the thing to know about Donald Trump in Utica is that Donald Trump hasn't done much to help the people of Utica. He's taken credit for certain job advances and so on, certain kind of economic expansion that began well before he took office, but the middle class still can't earn a decent living wage. The minimum wage is still not enough for people to live on. People still don't have adequate health care and all of that. But the thing to know about Utica is that what really helped it come back was that it became a hub city for refugees. So when I visited Utica last, a few years ago, the population would have fallen from 106,000 to about 48,000. Now imagine the devastation of losing more than 50% of your population. But because immigrants had been moving into Utica and settling there, the population was 59,000, which is considerably more, because 13,000 of the residents of Utica were refugees resettled from other parts of the country. So you had, and I wrote about this for Tricycle, the magazine, you had 3,000 Cambodians, for example. You had so many Bosnians that the old church on Main Street was now a mosque on Main Street. You had people from all around the world. I wrote about the monks from Burma who led the uprising there and were driven out of the country, settled just a block or so away from where I grew up. Now that's what's given Utica its strength. So the last kind of leader that a city like Utica needs is someone like Donald Trump coming in and bragging that he's done so much to revitalize the economy. Frankly, if we weren't on the air, I'd phrase this a little differently and say Donald Trump hasn't done blank for the people of Utica, but I can't say the blank on the air, FCC and all that, so I'm going to say instead that Donald Trump hasn't done squat for the people of Utica. You know what's done Utica the most good? The people that Donald Trump hates. The immigrants, the Muslims, the people of color. These are the people around the world who have come in and working hand-in-hand with the people of Utica have created jobs because immigrants do create jobs in this country. There are economic studies showing it. They create jobs. They create economic growth. We should be encouraging more immigration, especially from those countries we've decimated with our stupid war policies. So what cities like Utica need and cities around the country need is more immigrants, a whole lot more immigration, a whole lot more growth, a whole lot more government expansion, and a whole lot less Donald Trump.